The prophet you don't recognize cannot listen. When you're telling me your problem, I'm not seeing you. I am the big God who is bigger than that problem.
Help me look at somebody by your right hand side. Look into his or her eyes. Say to him, anytime there's a delay in miracles, God sends a prophet.
Grace has found me just as I am. Empty hand above
the love. Show me your faith and I will show you your miracle.
On Tuesday coming, that boy that quarreled with you is setting you up again, and their plan is to stab you with bottle on your head. When that happens on Tuesday, don't respond.
We're singing majesty.
The Bible says, if the foundation is shaken, what will the righteous do? I came to somebody this afternoon with a message. A message of hope. A message of faith. Just to let you know that problems may last, but they are not everlasting.
Turn with me to the book of Joel chapter number 1. Let me show you something as we continue in this glorious deliverance service. Whatever power that is holding you down, the Holy Ghost will set you free. Come, bring her. Come, the young man on glasses. Who is Ntute? Where are you? Ntute, come. The Lord is going to make you a financial statement in your father's house. Look at me. They've been trying to close the star of your family members. But listen, you will shine. The Lord will use you to close their mouths. Stand behind him. Father Holy Ghost. Let anointing to make wealth come on you. Yes, I transfer the grace of the Lord upon your life. You will shame the enemies of progress in your village. You will quench their armory. Grace come on you. Oh Jesus, let your anointing do this for this man. Where is your daddy? Sarah? Is at home. Where is your home? You're from Uru West. What does he do? He was teaching. A retired teacher. Right now, as he stands now, it's as if they're going to make caricature of your family, but they are lying. From this moment, victory has started happening. It's your portion. Yesterday was your birthday. Yesterday. Do you celebrate it? You celebrated it. I want to give you Holy Ghost birthday gift. Give me your hands. Sanama Lanisha La Karabas. Let anointing that destroys every yoke come upon you, son. Make you ranosa. Make you prominent. Make you prominent. Among your peers, make you stand tall amongst your equal. From this moment on, grace is multiplied in your life. In Jesus' mighty name, it's well with you. In Jesus' name, go. God bless you. Give the Lord a mighty clap offering. Is that the way you are clapping? Are you joking? Are you clapping? Listen. Come to me. Yes, sir. Come to me. When you start building and the enemy stop your building. It's not God's plan. Are you hearing what I'm saying now?
Yeah.
If you begin to build and all of a sudden the building stops, it's the finger of the enemy. And when God takes over, what the enemy has stopped, God begins it again. Are you listening to one? What's your name, sir? Samson who?
Joseph.
Joseph, from where, sir? From Ogwa?
Omaha.
The enemy have just stopped this building. It's as if everything, your husband. It will start again. You know what I'm talking about is true. By seeing it, Joma, I can confirm. Give him microphone. Open your hands. Nothing will fail in your hands again. Nothing will fail in your hands. From this moment, I anoint your hands. And I declare in the name of Jesus that whatever thing they have done to stop you from progressing, I cancel it. And I declare in the name of Jesus that from today, whatever thing that is not working in your life has started working. There's total restoration for you. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It will start again. Don't panic. It will start again. He who has begun a good work in your life will complete it. When God starts a work, he doesn't stop halfway. Do you know that? He's going to perfect what he has started in your life. As you travel back, you will see how doors will open for you. And you will know that there is God in Praise Tabernacle. Amen. Give the Lord a mighty clap, offering. Go back. It's well with you. It's well with you. I want to show you five things. Number one, what happened to these people? The list of destructions that happened to them. And I want to show you who did that to them. And then I want to tell you what they did or what God wants them to do so they can be free from cankerworm. All is found in Joel chapter number 1 from verse 1 to verse 20. I'm reading first verses 4 and 12. That which the palmer worm had left had the locusts eaten. And that which the locusts had left had the cankerworm eaten. And that which the cankerworm had left had the caterpillar eaten. Verse 12. The vine is dried up, and the fig tree languisheth. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field are withered, because joy is withered away from the sons of men. That's what happened to them. If you look at these scriptures, you see 10 things that happened to them. Number one, their new wine was cut off. Number two, the fig tree, the enemies came and harvested them by force. Number three, their young marriages began to suffer. There were all manner of divorce in the whole land. And those young married girls were dying even before their men wedding. The fourth thing that happened that was that pastors and ministers were suffering because offerings weren't coming to church anymore. The fifth thing that happened was that the land became unproductive. The sixth thing that happened was that the oil and wine were dried up. Their oil quickly dried up for no just reason. Their oil dried up. Imagine the oil of Nigeria drying up. Catastrophe. Their oil dried up. The seventh thing that happened was that their wheat and barley were destroyed in the farm by hoodlums. Number eight, all the economic trees were all destroyed. The ninth thing that happened was that their flock started dying out of starvation and hunger.
their flocks. And the tenth thing that happened was that the rivers dried up. The rivers dried up. The 11th was that the farms caught fire. All the farms caught fire. 11th thing that happens. When cankerworm attacks a family, the enemy, when he attacks a life, when he attacks a church, just cry tears everywhere. The Bible said that this particular family, this nation, they were attacked by cankerworm. What is cankerworm? Cankerworm, from the scriptures, we are seen as the enemies. Verses 6 and 7. He said, for a nation is come up upon my land, strong and without number, whose teeth are the teeth of a lion, and he had the sick teeth of a great nation, of a great lion. 7. He had laid my wine west and baked my fig tree. He had made it clean bare and cast away the branches thereof and made white. Cankerworms. They come like enemies of progress. When they come to your life, they mess your life up. A young man was here on Friday, and he said, I heard your voice over the radio, Pastor Larry, and I decided to come. He lives in Holland. He said in his entire community, the entire community, they built houses somewhere in Agua, but somehow they had clan clashes and they burnt the houses. He was one of the people that started building a magnificent building in his place. The moment he laid the foundation and they saw he was going to build the deepest, they sent jars to him. Within 2 weeks of leaving Nigeria back to where he lives in Holland, he lost his job. Immigration came after him and they sent him back to Nigeria. This is somebody that's married to a white person that have lived there, according to him, for 19 years. All of a sudden, they told him he had a fake paper. The wife called all the lawyers she could, but they said nobody can stand for him. He lost his papers. Since August last year till now, he's been in Nigeria. What happened to you? I don't know. What happened to your job? I don't know. What happened to your house? I don't know. I can't explain. And right now, the reason that brought him to church was that he sits down and he wee-wees on his body. Enemies of progress. As we are talking, say, Pastor, excuse me, can I please use your confidence? I looked at him 2 times. Say, okay, use. If I had wasted 7 seconds, yeah, because from the door as he was entering, full-fledged man, a master's degree holder, cankerworm. Cankerworm. They stopped his building, dealt with his health, dealt with his source of income. Cankerworm. The Bible said that they moved into the city and went to their farm. Farm represents their source of income, two of us. And they closed their source of income. Cankerworm are those things that go to your source of income and close it down. Cankerworm. Nahum was talking in the book of Nahum, chapter number 3, verse 16. He said, and the cankerworm came, spoiled, and flee. Cankerworm. I saw this lady I used to know. Her. Very tall, plump. But I just saw her recently. And she was just dry like hammer time. I was like, what's going on? She said, Pastor Larry, I don't know. I can't explain. We've gone to India. We've gone to some place. And they said, there is nothing wrong with me. My test reads nothing. But I'm dying. That's to tell you how tiny this woman is. What is wrong with you? She brought her medical reports. Nothing was found. What has happened to her? Cankerworm attacked her health. Cankerworm.
Thank you. Cankerworm. A man said to me, he walked in 17 places. He never walked more than 10 days. After the ninth day, he'll be fired. He will walk after ninth day, he'll be fired. He will walk after 9 days to be fired. 17 places, fired after 9 days. Cankerworm. 17 places. Fired. At every single place he goes to work, he did not pass 9 days. The 10th day, as he's resuming, they fire him. And he decided and started his own establishment. He started setting up a small accounting firm. He's an accountant, a chartered accountant. He set up a small accounting firm. And that was what he was using to sustain himself and his family because of connections from his in-laws and the father. Were where to do. He was getting small things. Not until the year 2012, everything closed down his life. As he stands right now, he told me that I am a keke driver. I looked at him. Chartered accountant driving keke. What happened to your certificate? I don't know. What happened to your life? I don't know. I said, I know. Cankerworm! I've done this to you. Cankerworm. Cankerworm finished the life of that chartered accountant that he could not take care of his family. I don't know who is listening to me this morning. We are going to wage war against cankerworm. Help me look at somebody by your side. Say, every cankerworm in your life will be roasted by fire today. Shout amen like you know it. That amen is suffering from quite shocker. Cankerworm came, ate, and disappeared. Cankerworm. I saw a man I used to know. He lives by ABC Transport, my two. I got to know him because a pastor introduced him to him. So anytime we go to Lagos, in those days, we are running around as boys of God or boys for God. So we stay in his house and wait until they start loading. And then I saw him. He had cars. I remember in those days, I used to use one of his small cars to take us to the ABC Transport. And then we come out like big boys and enter the car. I saw him along Douglas Road. I had already passed, so I parked my car and jumped out of the car, running. And finally he turned. I didn't know. Ha! Pastor! Oh, were you the one calling? I thought it wasn't me. I said, it's me. Come. What is it? He said, Pastor, I'm running to go and meet somebody at Bank Road in the bank. He promised to give me 5,000 naira. Okay, running to meet somebody to give you 5,000 naira. You. Running to meet appointment for 5,000 naira. Excuse me, sir. Come here. What happened? It's a long story, Pastor. I can't tell you. We're in the village now. I said, where's your village? Same be, sir. We've been in the village for 4 years. What happened? Pastor, I can't explain. Oh, Tumshi, you're here. I just got to the office one day. And before I said Jack Robinson, all my staff started resigning. Before I said the next one, all the customers that used to bring something for us to distribute, all of them started withdrawing their certificates. One thing led to the other. One thing, I just got on angry and just locked up the office. 2 weeks later, my wife encouraged me to go back because she's a teacher. I got to the office. I didn't see anybody to work with. And that's the end of it. I said, this story you're telling me, are you telling me IFOD or AKUIFO? Which one is it? He said, that's what happened. For 4 years, I have been in the village. What happened to you? What happened to a man that when we come, he will use either his Mercedes, Concord Mercedes, to drop us, or he will use the other Jeep to drop us, or he will have 3 cars, and he was occupying the double flat, 4-bedroom flat, this side and this side, occupying it by himself, no stress. Now he's been in the village for 4 years, begging for food. What happened to him? Cankerworm. Cankerworm have finished the man. I don't know who is listening to me now. I don't know what cankerworm had done to you. I don't know what cankerworm had done to your marriage. I know what cankerworm had done to your academia. You see some students, when they are in primary school, secondary school, they will top the class. The first five, the first ten, they are there. But right now, second year, third year, they are carrying over courses. Nine all over. And you'll be asking, what is wrong with you? I don't know. Pastor, I can't even read again. If I read, I don't understand. What has happened to that brain? Cankerworm has damaged the brain. Cankerworm. You are enjoying your relationship with this young man. Enjoying every good part of it. All of a sudden, one daughter of Jezebel appears from nowhere. And you call your guy again. He said, I'm busy. That's why I'm not picking your call. Don't worry, I'll call you. 2 days he has not called. What is wrong? Okay, did I offend you? No, he didn't do anything. Just that I'm not too good for you again. You're too good for me. Too good for where? He's looking for excuse to tell you that a daughter of Jezebel has taken over your position. What has happened to you? Cankerworm. Every cankerworm that have decided to attack your relationship. If I serve a living God, after this service, your father will roast them with his fire. That amen is suffering from a shocker. Can you shout the loudest amen you can afford? After this service, every cankerworm holding your marriage, holding your fiance, holding your fiancee, holding your life, after this service, your God will set you free. Your God will set you free. No cankerworm will succeed in your life. Suffered for a long time. I came to tell you that the day of suffering are over. Anybody hearing what I'm saying now? The days of suffering are over. Help me tell somebody by your side, your suffering are over. You can't struggle again. Cankerworm. I am tired of what cankerworm has done to the body of Christ. Today, somebody is enjoying. The next day, no longer. You can't even find food and put on his table. The question is, has God changed? Does he change? Is it the will of God that you suffer? Why are you suffering? Cankerworm. He has come to steal. He has come to take your relationship, to take your pregnancy. Chinedu, when was that? A lady came and said that this is her 20th miscarriage. Miscarriage. 20th. 20th. And the doctors warned her and told her not to take in again because her womb is finished. I know her too well. She called me to convince the husband so that they can adopt a baby. A lady of 34 years old said, medical report says, don't try again. Your womb, even if you try, your womb can't carry. Because of what? Miscarriages. When men slept, the enemy came in and planted ties. Cankerworm. You turn this way, it does not work. You turn the other way, it does not work. What is happening? Cankerworm. Had come to take away your joy. Am I talking to anybody in this house? Help me ask your neighbor, what is it that the cankerworm has stolen in your life? The Bible says that men do not despise a thief when he's stealing to console himself. But when that thief is caught, he shall restore sevenfold what he has lost. We know who the thief is now. That cankerworm in your life, we have discovered the cankerworm. Whatever they have stolen in your life, whatever they have stolen in your family, I prophesy, after this service, they will restore. They will restore. God 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 will restore. Someone shall fire. He said, I will restore to you the years that the cankerworm, the palmerworm have eaten in your life. How long have you been doing this? How long? He said, the years that the cankerworm cankerworm have taken in your life, I will restore them. Meaning that after this service, what you remember and shed tears, you will not remember them again. Oh, come on, that amen is not good at all. Shout a better amen, let me hear you. We are going to wage war against cankerworm. This is what touched me. He said, the reason this is happening is because the church have refused to pray. Verse 13 says, guide yourself and lament, ye priests, all ye ministers of the altar. Come, lie all night in sackcloth, you ministers of my God, for the meat offering and the drink offering, withholding from the house of your God. How can you bring it back? Prayer. Number 14, he says, sanctify ye a fast. Call a solemn assembly. Gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land into the house of the Lord, your God. And do what? Cry unto the Lord. And he will restore back. I don't know about you, but this service, in the first 10 minutes, before we begin to prophesy, this is a prophetic service. We are going to cry to God. Some people, by the time they collect their salary, it's already gone. They collected their salary to distribute. Nkechi, gakwa pharmacy ogwa, ego le 20,000. Bia, chiboy, gakwa monye mechanic ogwa, ego le kaijia 30,000. Bia, kwa mwani gara ogwa, ibuliole 10,000. Bia, mwani condiment, ikwala, ndi supermarket, hey, eche fulema, ndi supermarket, kwa hongwa, eche ego le, hey, nkai natra mwe milia, ikwala, ego le fronga, honi ogula, gini, some gather salaries to distribute. Cankerworm. The same salary you are distributing, people have been training students in university with the same amount of money. The same salary you are collecting, and the enemy has blown on it. You collect 70,000, 100,000, 20,000, 30,000. There are families, they live by that, and they don't complain. Why is yours not enough? Cankerworm. Cankerworm. There's nothing that you do that you can get satisfaction from. Every single thing you do, cankerworm will attack it. We are going to pray. I don't know about anybody here. If my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, I will hear from heaven and I will heal their land. I don't know about you. I want to talk about myself. The enemy came at a point and dealt with my family, dealt with us terribly. It came to a point where others will go to school and will not go to school. My father will carry us to church compulsorily for fasting and prayer because there's no money to pay school fees. It was Solomon in the book of Ecclesiastes, he said, there's an evil under the sun. He said that the priests are walking on the barefoot on the floor, whereas the servants are riding on horses' back. He said, it's an evil. Anybody in this church hearing me? Is anybody hearing me now? Someone shout, evil! It's an evil. He said, let us pray. He said, call upon me. I will restore back to you the years, the days, the months. I am glad to preach to somebody here because I know that after this service, what you have lost, it is not what is coming back, but good measure. Press down, shake it together, and running over. Good measure. Press down, shake it together, and running over. Good measure. Press down, shake it together, and running over. Good measure. Press down, shake it together, and running over. Good measure. Press down, shake it together. That's what God will give you. I am tired of the level where I am. I am tired of begging. I am tired of asking people to help me. Bible said, me, I will distribute to many nations. Who am I talking to right now? Your portion is not to beg.
Your portion is to distribute. Your portion is not to beg. Your portion is to lend to many nations. And I came to let you know that the year is the caterpillar and the cankerworm have eaten in your life. After this service, there is going to be a change. The Holy Ghost will move you from the level of begging to the level of giving, from the level of begging to the level of distribution, because the anointing of the Lord is coming down upon you. Somebody shout hallelujah in the house. I will restore to you. I will give back to you. To restore means to give back. It means to make good. It means to add back. It means to replace. It means to bring back in quantum whatever you have lost. My brother, I came to tell somebody here who have lost a good relationship because of the enemies. Right now, I prophesy to you, after this service, a better relationship is coming to you. Help me look at somebody by your side. Ask him or her, what is that cankerworm in your family? Do you know that there are some people who are tenants in their village? How many of you know that? In their father's village, they don't have a house. They are tenants in the village. That's the highest kind of insult that can happen to anybody. Your grandfather could not build a house. Your father did not build a house. And the village, you are renting a house in your village. Error. How can a young man finish work from school, service, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years? All those enemies of progress, getting employment, are they bigger than your God? Help me ask somebody by your side, are they bigger than your God?
Thank you so much for watching. I'm sure you have been truly blessed. To share your praise report or prayer request, SMS Pastor Larry on the number showing on your screen, or you can email us at larrymichelle123@gmail.com. God bless you.